This is a quick response to Nykytyne2 and your latest posting on modern art there. Nick, I think I'm in an appropriate place to comment for some reason, I'm down to. Where the hell am I? I'm at the Centre Pompidou in Paris. And there's lots of art around here, and I've just been listening to an introduction to a conference which used the word art a bazillion times. But there's just two bits I want to pick up on your video there, which is the follow-up to the modern art scam video. The first is, the first thing you say in this is, how much would you pay for this painting? And you show this picture of a colour field painting. Yeah, I mean, if you're asking that question, you're asking the wrong question. You know, I mean, it's a confusion of price and value. It's a distraction. And yes, I would absolutely say that, you know, a lot of 20th century, the whole idea of art has been corrupted in many ways by its association with kind of mercantile culture and exchange culture, of course. And the fact that that's the first thing that comes to people's minds when we see that, you know, or when and you put it in their minds in the first sentence you say, as I say, it's a complete distraction. No, of course it's not worth all that money, and people are stupid to pay that amount for it. But that's not the point. It's just not the point. Yeah, the other thing is this Emperor's Got New Clothes thing. I mean, you mentioned that in the previous video, and you mentioned it again here. Yes, you're right, the Emperor has the Emperor is naked, the Emperor has not. You know, it's one of those things. But, you know, who wants to live in a bloody empire? I mean, that's kind of the point, you know. The empire of the senses that is being pointed toward in the kind of art that you said you like, you know, the plays of Shakespeare and the various painters that you've mentioned. And I'm not disputing the beauty and the technical aplomb that they're produced with, or any of those kind of things, or the aesthetic quality of those things. But they appeal to a certain kind of empire, you know. And if the 20th century is about anything, it's about radical changes in what constitutes social organisation, what constitutes political organisation, you know, what constitutes authority and power and control and mediatisation. And, you know, there's a lot of struggles around that. And one of those struggles is absolutely about, you know, who mandates power of the aesthetic experience. And, you know, traditionally, the arbiters of power, the arbiters of taste in terms of aesthetic experience are the emperors, and they're the only ones who have had access to those things. But it's not them that's having the experiences, it's the people who have the experiences, it's the people who are viewing the artworks, it's the people who are sitting at the concert of classical music or sitting in their flat listening to the classical music. It's those people who are having that experience. And, you know, if John Cage is going to point out that, hey, look, you know, you're doing this, then that's interesting. You know, if Malevich is going to point out the beauty of colour resides in the perception of that, then that's an interesting thing. It's a different project, you know what I mean? You're comparing apples and oranges. Yeah, that's bits, really. Yeah, I mean, it's just those two things. I mean, there's a lot of things to be said. But, yeah, comparing price and value is a non-starter. Whoever does it, you know, whether it's done in order to, you know, to increase the value of Saatchi and Saatchi owners, you know, products that they've come into possession of, or whether it's by people like yourself who are using these price value analogy as a means of condemning people's artworks, then that's a problem. And the other thing is the emperor has no clothes. No, it's not. The whole point is, do we really need emperors? Do we really need emperors? I'll just end on this picture. I find this very disturbing. It's just a guy holding a conch. I guess it's a conch shell. Look at that. Ugh. Anyhow, enough of that.